In the last video, we talked about differential equations where dy dx only depended on x or only depended on y. Now we're going to talk about a class of equations where it depends on both, but we still can solve it. Most equations where it depends on both are just too hard. But if dy dx can be written as either the product or the ratio of a function of x and a function of y, and it's really the same because multiplying by a function of y is the same thing as dividing by its reciprocal, then we can solve it. If you can write dy dx as a function of x divided by a function of y, then you cross multiply and you get the g of y dy is f of x dx, and then you integrate both sides. Now you have to know how to do your integrals, but you get some function of y, let's call it capital G because its derivative is little g, is equal to some function of x, let's call it capital F, and then you always have an arbitrary constant. Now you might wonder, why don't we have two constants, one for each side? Well, you could say that there's a constant here and a constant here, but then you just subtract off the first constant from both sides, and a constant minus another constant is just a constant, and we call this whole thing C. So from now on, we're not going to bother writing constants on both sides. Whenever we have two integrals, we'll write your favorite antiderivative over here is equal to your favorite antiderivative over here plus one constant. Okay. Now, once you've got it there, what you'd really like is to get y as a function of x, or maybe x as a function of y. It's not always possible. When it is possible, it's a good idea to do so. Okay, so let's take a look at an example. So let's suppose that we're told that dy dx is x over y, and that when x is 0, y is 4. And the question is, what is y when x is 3? And for that matter, what is y in general? So this is separable. It's a function of x divided by a function of y. So we do our cross multiplication, and we get y dy equals x dx. Then we integrate both sides, and we get y squared over 2 is x squared over 2 plus a constant. In other words, y squared is x squared plus another constant, which is twice the first constant. Okay, that's a hyperbola. Now we plug in 0, 4, and we get that 16 is 0 squared plus twice the constant, so that twice the constant must be 16, and we get that the equation is y squared equals x squared plus 16. So when x is 3, you say 9 plus 16 is 25, take the square root of that, and the answer is 5. So a picture of a solution, actually the curve y squared equals x squared plus 16 is a hyperbola which has two pieces, one up here and one down here. But since we went through this point, the point 0, 4, as we track our way out along the hyperbola, we only get this piece. There's no way to jump over to this side. So this, it solves the differential equation, but it's not consistent with our initial condition. So what we really have is the hyperbola y squared equals x squared plus 16, and y is positive. In other words, y is the square root of x squared plus 16. There we go. We solved the differential equation. As another example, let's suppose we had dy dx is cosine of x divided by y squared. Well, cross multiply, integrate both sides. You get y cubed over 3 is sine of x plus a constant. So y is 3 sine of x plus a constant, all cube rooted. Y cubed is 3 sine of x plus a constant. So y is the cube root of 3 sine of x plus a constant. And I marked that as a c prime just to show that this constant isn't exactly the same as this constant. It's actually 3 times the original constant. That doesn't matter. Still, arbitrary constant. So our last example, let's look at dy dx equals y times the tangent of x. This looks a bit more complicated. But the procedure is the same. It's a function of y times a function of x. We bring the function of y to the other side, bring the dx to this side, we get dy over y, equals tangent of x dx. And of course, tangent of x dx is sine x over cosine of x dx. And that suggests a u substitution, where you let u be cosine of x. This is minus du over u. So the integral of this is the integral of this, is the integral of this, is the integral of this. And we get the natural log of y is minus the natural log of the cosine of x plus a constant. So exponentiate both sides, and we get the absolute value of y is 1 over the cosine of x times a constant. In other words, y is a constant times the secant of x. Looked like a hard problem. It was separable. You walk through it, you do an integral of the y function, you do an integral of the x function, and then you do some manipulations to turn this equation into an actual equation for y in terms of x.